chemical catalysis is all about speed. It's making a reaction that seems impossibly slow go at a reasonable rate. And in this webcast and the webcasts that follow, we're going to take a close look at what are the mechanisms behind catalysis and some of the other key concepts. Let's start with a definition of what a catalyst is. A catalyst is a substance, and the bottom line is it makes a reaction go faster. And so because of that, a catalyst is a substance that's going to somehow show up in a rate expression. And later on in the next webcast, we're going to take a look at exactly what that means for the catalyst to show up in the rate expression. Importantly, however, it doesn't show up in the stoichiometry. It's not going to appear in the balanced chemical equation. So how is it, in general terms, that a catalyst works? Let's look at a free energy diagram. And really, a catalyst works by altering the free energy of activation. And it can do this in a couple of different ways. It could either lower the transition state energy. It could bring the transition state energy down. That's one way it could do it. It could also destabilize the reactants. It could push the energy of the reactant up and make it move closer to the free energy of activation associated with the transition state. That's a second way that delta G double dagger could be affected. And the third way, which is actually illustrated by the red curve here that I'll trace out, is that a catalyst could open up a completely new chemical pathway. And by doing so, that new pathway that may be available in the presence of the catalyst would have an activation energy that's lower. The key parameter that makes a catalyzed reaction proceed at a fast rate relative to the uncatalyzed reaction is this term delta delta G double dagger, which is just the difference in free energy between the delta G double dagger for uncatalyzed reaction versus catalyzed reaction. And it's representing this purple arrow here, which is the difference between the peak-to-peak transition state energies of those two different pathways. Notice that the free energy change associated with transforming A into B doesn't change in the presence of the catalyst. That's the difference between going from the reactants to the products. Let's try to get a handle on just how much free energy stabilization is needed in order to accelerate a reaction at a significant degree. We'll use the Arrhenius equation, and rather than delta G double dagger, we're going to just substitute this experimentally determined activation energy, EACT, and we'll use this Arrhenius equation, which relates the rate coefficient, K, small k, that's the rate coefficient that would appear in a rate expression, to that free energy of activation. What we're really interested in is a ratio of rate coefficients, a rate coefficient for the catalyzed reaction versus a rate coefficient for the uncatalyzed reaction. We want to take the ratio of those two, and since the term delta G, or activation energy, appears in the expression that is an exponent, we'll basically just subtract those, and we have the overall change that's either the delta delta G double dagger, or if we're just using this experimental activation energy, we just call it delta E double dagger. How large does delta E have to be? Well, it doesn't have to be very large at all. Just a few kilocalories per mole of stabilization is enough to bring about a rate change that's on the order of a million-fold faster. A catalyzed reaction being a million times faster if it can just find 8 kilocalories per mole of stabilization compared to the uncatalyzed reaction. Enzymes operate in the range of working a million to 10 to the 14th times faster. And so they find at least 8 to up to 10 or 12 kilocalories per mole of stabilization. Let's take a look at some very generic ways that catalysis comes about. Catalysts are either going to be acids or bases, and we'll take a great look in detail at some of these. We'll spend the bulk of our time in webcasts that follow on acidic and basic catalyzed reactions and the mechanisms of them. We'll find also that nucleophiles can catalyze reactions. So just to set us straight, the idea of a catalyst, in this case an acid-catalyzed hydrolysis reaction, that's the reaction that we're going to study in detail in the next webcast, you can see that the methyl acetate is converted into acetic acid, and acid appears on both sides. When acid is present, the rate of the reaction is accelerated, but because it's a catalyst and it doesn't appear in the stoichiometry, it's coming on both sides of the equation, and so we can end up crossing it off from the stoichiometry, but it makes the rate of the reaction go a lot faster.